Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. BB&T Field in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. We give you a live look in the final moments before kickoff. Warm-ups just concluding. Everybody make sure those hammies are nice and loose as we get set to tee it up. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Fred Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He's out to the 30, and he's taken down at the 37. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive.
Tight end to move the chains, you got a big time advantage over any defense.
First and 10, ball on the 50-yard line. Tackle after a decent pickup.
That makes it second and 6.
They get nice yardage on that run. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. And he's tackled at the 41-yard line. Sullivan gains about a yard on the play. Right now, he wants to get this kick away and change field position. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Nevada's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
He takes it right side for a good game.
That brings him second and 5.
He gets to about the 34-yard line. That was a great call.
Yeah, here you see the draw play at its best. The tailback got good blocking up front and was able to pick up a bunch of yards.
Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver. That one sailed on it.
He wanted his receiver, but I think that may have slipped out of his hands.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. He's scrambling. And now he's going to improvise. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 47-yard line. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
Makes the catch, and look out. Jones picks him up 6 yards with a catch.
That'll make it make it second and four.
Here's the halfback on the screen. Tackle made
at about the 37-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
They come out on an empty backfield. Going to try and scramble. Slides down. Good awareness on that scramble there.
They dropped everybody back in coverage and left enough running room for the big guy to get a first down.
Now he's scrambling. Room around the corner. He takes off. The five. Touchdown, Nevada. Hits the PAT.
A 9-play, 80-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
And the big plays that they had running the football were the keys to that drive.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Morris from the five. They'll bring him down at the 28. Nevada's really got things working right now for them. I can't think of a better start.
Well, that's exactly the way they had hoped to see this game go. I mean, anytime you can start the game with a stop, get your offense out there, they move the ball down, put points on the board. Now it's just more about trying to maintain what they've already created.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Brady drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
Second and 10. Ball on the 28.
Ready. Red 18. Red 18.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
That is just a great play getting into the backfield. This guy is so quick that the ball carrier never had a chance. Effort there by the defense. They weren't giving up anything on that series.
Garrett awaits the snap. Tackle made at the 42-yard line.
The last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
He has some room. Down the sideline. Touchdown. The extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Off to University Park we go, and for UTEP, they're looking to win their third straight. The Miners are on top 10-7.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. Franklin has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 31-yard line. Nevada's defense really came to play early in this football game.
Well, they've done a good job here early, but you know eventually this offense is going to start clicking. Let's see if this defense can sustain this for the rest of the game.
They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game.
Ground 50! Ground 50!
It's second and 10.
Ball on their own 31.
Ready! Green 19! Green 19!
Throws out to the back, and it's through his hands.
Sullivan, the intended receiver on the play. That brings up third and 10.
Chance to show what he can do.
Oh, he sure does, and he doesn't disappoint either. Great athletic ability.
From the 43-yard line, first down. He's out of bounds around the 39-yard line. Is right, and he's taken down at the 38.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That'll make it 35.
So we're looking at another third down here. Complete. He's got room. He's taken down at about the 27-yard line.
This is a quarterback who trusts his receivers, and he knows they can make plays. It's like those two were playing catch out there.
We've played one quarter. Nevada leads 14-0. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. And he's got his man. He's tackled around the 19-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Ready! Ready!
Throws middle of the tight end, and down he goes at the 15-yard line. This is the ninth play of this drive. Tackle at the 15.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From the 15-yard line, second down. Pass. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 11. Campbell picks up about 4 yards with a catch. Here's the 11th play of the drive.
Ready. Check, check. Big dog.
And that sets them up for the first and goal. Score game, and they can cut that down here if they can get this one in the end zone. He gets rid of this one. Thirteenth play of the drive coming up. Defense backed up into their own end zone. It's third and goal from the one.
Let's go.
They go with a run, and they stopped him.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage. gets up,
and he's got it. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
Time for an update from University Park. This one's been entertaining us all day long. And for SMU, they love to unleash their running attack. A nifty zip into the end zone for the score. SMU in front, 20-17.
All right, Reese, back to our game. Wake Forest, the kick. He's to the 20. And he just got stood up right there. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. And they make the stop at the 23.
You've got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. He's to the 40. He's knocked out of bounds around the 42-yard line. First down. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. There he goes. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. First down. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's tackled at about the 19-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
From the 19-yard line, it's first down. Scrambling around. It's a fumble. It's picked up. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Tries to buy some time, and they get the sack. So the sack makes this third and very long. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen, and they got him for a loss. That makes it fourth and long. Toss. Throws. Complete touchdown.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
You talk about a clutch play. They couldn't afford any mistakes on fourth down there.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. Franklin looks ready to kick this one off. Morris takes it at the 8. Morris.
think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Demon Deacons on this, taking their first time out of the half.
This was a great call. From here, it looked like the defense was fooled and reacted a little bit late to the screen.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 44.
Here we go. Green 90. Green.
Throws it on the run. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
It out to about the 20.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well, but the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
He heaves it to the end zone.
Incomplete. We've played a half of football. Nevada leads 21-3.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick, you know, be able to strip the ball out. Get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know, do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kurt.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Caught at the 8. Brought down at the 32.
Well, this is one of those days when everything is clicking for an offense. These guys have been executing, and that's the reason they have such a nice lead.
This offense has really seemingly been unstoppable. Should be interesting to see now if the defense has changed things up as they try to stop these guys. Up the middle for a nice gain. Win gains about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it second and 6.
Strike and he drops it.
I know this quarterback trusts his arm and his receivers, but he's got to know when not to throw the ball. He didn't have any room at all, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted.
From their own 36-yard line, it's third down. Fires it out. And he's level at the 36-yard line.
is waiting for the snap. They'll bring him down at the 36. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Fires out to his receiver. Tackle made at the 44.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. And he carried that one for a few yards.
You know, when you have a guy that can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure takes some of the pressure off the passing game.
His man, first down.
Man, that is a great call and a big game, especially on an early down.
From the 40-yard line, first down. Tackle for a loss.
Loss of three on the play. That brings up second and 13.
Fires out to his wideout, and he's tackled right away. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Nice gain as he works the right side. The PAT. A nice 7-play, 64-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He'll return it from the 6, and he's taken down at the 30-yard line. Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out. Field out of bounds around the 35-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Come on out here. Come get some. You don't want it. Check.
He scrambled. They'll bring him down around the 47-yard line.
Well, this is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
That makes it first and 10.
Get to the ball.
And now he's got room to run. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. And he's taken down around the 32-yard line.
That'll bring up 36.
They come out in a five-wide set. With the pass, incomplete. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Now he's scrambling. And he hits him hard at the 17. Makes it to the 8.
That brings up second and 9.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. Here's an opening. He takes it right side for a good game.
Gain of 7 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Hold on, hold on. Let's go. On the ball. Quick.
Tackle at the 5-yard line.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved them back.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the 5. Touchdown, Wolfpack. The quarterback just made that one look pretty simple.
Well, this quarterback isn't your average player. He runs the option very well and gives this defense fits.
Converts the extra point. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese.
Madison and for Wisconsin, let's keep an eye on this game where a major surprise could be brewing. The Wildcats on top by 3.
Well, if that score holds up, that would be water cooler talk on Monday morning. Franklin has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. From the 7. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Nevada's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out. And most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback. And the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
That's 3 down and 1 to go. Nevada's up by 18. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. He's on the run. He's to the 40. He's tackled right around the 44-yard line. From their own 44-yard line, first down. Fires right side. Got his tailback. He's taken down at the 45-yard line. Receiver, and that's a first down. Brought down at about the 39-yard line. First down.
First down.
first and 10. Ball on the 39. Strike to his receiver, no good.
There's one the quarterback would like to rewind because he has a wide open receiver and he just misfires.
Around the 41-yard line.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That makes it third and 11.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29.
What great concentration. He left his feet, made the catch, and managed to secure it when he hit the ground. That was just sensational.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From the 25-yard line, it's second down. He guns it left side, and this one falls incomplete.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver and maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Fumble, loose ball, and it's picked up by one of the linemen. He tackles him for a loss. A man down, and the trainer's on their way out to have a look. So they're going to go for it here. Just under three to go in regulation. Throwing left. And he can't hang on to it. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
You aren't going to convert many fourth downs against this defense. That's a really good stop. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. And they make the stop around the 37-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10 following that big run. At the 20, and they push him out
at about the 11.
That was a huge lift.
Brad, you're right. A run like that can really get the momentum rolling.
From the 11-yard line, it's first down. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. And down he goes at the 2. Just over a minute left.
He's scrambling. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown.
Simpson's game shows us a little bit of everything today. We've seen his arm, and now we see him do it with his legs.
I love to watch a quarterback take a game over, and it's the worst nightmare for a defensive coordinator is when a quarterback is able to make a big play with his feet. It's the one guy you just can't account for as a defense, and that time he made him pay for it.
He makes the PAT. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
They are lighting up the scoreboard again in the Big 12. And for Rice, they take to the air and find pay dirt. Rice leads it 7-0. In another game, the football's flying all over the lot in the Big 12. And for SMU, they've now dumped 4 in a row.
And we thank you, Reese Davis. The action here. Nevada is ready to kick it away. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 24. Well, late in the fourth quarter, this game has been over for a long time, and now we just want to get out of here like these two teams do. Pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
That makes it second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on 24. Under a minute left. On the catch. Oh, they strip it out.
That's pretty much the best way to make sure the receiver doesn't catch it. He just put his pads on him the second he touched it.
A blowout and has been for most of the game. I think it's time for everybody to go home.
Garrett is the punter. And he muffed it.
The coach gets the 150th win of his career, Herbie. It just goes to show you what a really fine coach he is. We want to congratulate him.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries.
Here we go.
Takes a knee. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, Nevada 35, Wake Forest 10.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.